同学们大家好，下面咱们展开本次课程的最后一小节，还回到第一小节提出这个问题。富士康他想用机器人代替人，但是好像实际动静跟预期相比有很大的差距，那么这个问题就归结为机器人是否可以完全代替工人呢？我们看这两个事情，咱先不管富士康本身他怎么样，我们先看本身相关的一些有关的这个报道。78年的时候，日本一家公司它的切割机器人在切钢板，但是呢它突然发生了异常，把一个工人当做钢板给切了，那你肯定人就受不了了。到了82年呢，日本又发生了一个事情，这个机器人为这个对象上要加工螺纹，但结果呢他没有把这个对象抱起来，他把这工人抱起来，把这工人给刻上螺纹了，这也造成了悲剧。日本一直是比较推崇这个机器人，虽然可能他日本一直非常推崇这个机器人，所以他的用的非常广泛也非常充分，但是呢也就出现这些事情。那么分析这个机器人杀人也好，它的背后原因是什么呢？可能大概有三类。一类真的就是硬件系统本身出故障了，或者你年久失修，或者说它里面有些材料或者什么的产生了异常。那第二类呢，可能是你的程序出了问题，程序跑它也不是说完全没有问题的，咱们用手机它也会死机，那你这个机器人它运行中如果突然死机或突然异常，可能就会操作就跟原来不一样。那么还有可能呢是电磁波的干扰，你可能中间本来是这么去走的，突然有一个干扰源进来，把你的信号完全打乱了，让你不知道怎么去执行了，这个都有些原因。那么机器人伤人或机器人杀人，这个属于偶然的还是属于必然呢？我们其实可以这么去看这个事情，机器人相对而言它毕竟是一个新生的事物，那么所有新生事物一出现的时候呢，它不可能总是完善总是完美的。像刚才那种报道是1970年1980年的事情，那么随着现在的机器人技术的不断进步呢，这种事情呢是其实越来越少的，近几年就没有再听说过有类似事件发生了。应该来讲，这个由于机器人更安全的更可靠的做了这些事情，才是人们现在大力的想用机器人，这也是其中一个重要的原因。那么所以说用机器人是应该是好的，这种伤害会很小的，但是你机器人都把这事干了，那人是不是就失业了？你看咱们改革的时候呢，这个香港工人带来社会不稳定的因素是很重要的一个不稳定因素。原来咱们有大量的纺织工去在这去纺纱，现在都机器人完成了，那这些人干什么去？这种风险是不是存在呢？总体上看，我们是这么个结论，应该是利大于弊。某些工种我们认为是会消失，但是呢我们还会产生新的工种。消失呢是一些低级的简单的劳动，你不需要学什么知识，不需要什么懂什么技术，可能你挣的薪水也不高，那这种事情呢很快可能会被机器人代替。你要想获得工作，你可能得先去学习，那么有些工种呢会新的产生，这些事呢可能就是目前这个机器人完成不了的，比如它可能过于复杂过于灵活，或者呢它需要一定的治理能力，或者呢它需要比较高的知识水平，这些是什么呢？目前机器还达不到，包括这种技术含量。那么这种工作呢往往意味着高薪水，那么你原来你由低薪水变为高薪水，其实对你来讲是有好处的。我们来看看这种观点的 一个视频。
This is a mobile robot. This is a robot that can navigate and drive its way through environments where there's walls.
Robots making the rounds are a common sight at the offices of Adept Technologies. Adept is one of the companies designing the next generation of robotics. And in the future, how they adapt may be just as important as how much they accomplish.
And there it goes.
Robots have been performing rote tasks like welding auto frames for decades. But a new generation that can handle delicate, irregular objects and adapt to assembly line shifts is poised to change manufacturing around the world. At Earthbound Farm in Central California, Adept robots pack boxes of organic mixed greens right alongside workers.
There is a great amount of care that it takes to get the product from the field to the fork in a safe and efficient manner. And I see robots as the next wave of that efficiency gain.
For years, many manufacturing workers have been trained to be more precise and machine-like. Comedians like Charlie Chaplin and Lucille Ball poked fun at the speed and complexity of modern manufacturing.
You're doing splendidly. Speed it up!
But today, it is machines that are ever more human in their abilities. Grippers and hands can now handle delicate electronics and irregular foodstuffs. Thanks to advances in optical recognition technology, they are also able to determine if a part is out of place and adapt in real time.
This is a software test bed that we have, but what it really shows is how well vision, sight, and robots can be integrated together to be able to dynamically tell the robot where product is. And it'll do it at very high rates of speed. And what I'll show you is I'll move some of the product in the belt, and you'll see the robot seamlessly moves over and adapts to where that product is to make the same motion.
These advances are of obvious benefit at a factory like Earthbound Farm, where for now, robots pack uniform boxes, but may soon be doing even more.
Not only can you pick up weird shaped things and orient them correctly, but you can also view them through the arms of that robot. And so you can incorporate quality inspections to that process, or any number of different things can all come together at that one station, where it might have taken us four or five stations in the past to reach that same objective.
Human workers, the company says, will be trained for higher level jobs.
You know, we don't view the robot as a way to eliminate the labor. It's just really an opportunity for us to raise that skill set and help everybody realize a better life as a result of that. You know, get them out of that repetition and get them into a place where they can earn a higher wage and be more successful.
Earthbound calculates that robotics may speed up its packing line by as much as 30%. The production streamlining and accuracy of modern robotics may lure manufacturers from Asia back to the United States, even for precision goods like solar panels and cell phones.
You know, I think that robotics is going to lead to a renaissance in American manufacturing. The ability to build products here as cost-effectively as anywhere else in the world. And it will mean that there will be a mix of people and robots working together to create the jobs of the future and the manufacturing of the future.
那么关于这个问题，现在还没有一个定论，我们希望都会有一个好的这个结局。人既从繁重的劳动中解出来，同时呢，人的生活啊还要好好的保障，人不能没有工作。那么最后呢，向大家推荐一个视频，这个是老梁观世界在2012年8月20号的，他也对这个问题进行了讨论，大家可以通过他的观点给大家一个启发，谢谢。